Ooh. Loud as hell.
Right.
It's cracking with the gang, you hear me? We back with another one and shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah, you can hear yourself, huh? All right.
One, two, three, yep.
All right, bet. We back with another one, gang, you know what I'm saying?
Back with another one.
Shout out my nigga Josh P pulling up. Yes, fuck with the movement, you know what I'm saying? So where you from for the people who don't know, my boy?
I'm from Sacramento, California, South Sac, Florence. So.
Okay, so you've been here your whole life?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
How you feeling it? Like, how you feeling it?
I feel like the scene is booming. I left to Fresno for like Fresno State and stuff, and then that didn't work out. So I just came back recently and just started grinding. Started
what was going on in Fresno, bro?
Man, it was so hard to network out there. Like the network system out there isn't really what it is out here. And I was like, I knew I didn't even want to be in college out there to begin with. So I was like,
what made you go over there?
Honestly, it was just I felt like getting away for a second because I was like, well, do I want to go to Sac State or somewhere else? And I was like, well.
Somewhere else.
Yeah, and I didn't know nothing about Fresno for real. And everybody was warning me about it. And then I got out there and I experienced it. And I was like, damn.
Time to go back home.
Yeah, so.
That's crucial.
As soon as I came back here, like a month ago, I think. And I just started working like immediately because I knew I wanted to take music seriously. So I just started trying to connect with everybody and get well acquainted and stuff like that. So
getting it together, showing face and shit.
Yes, sir.
That's how it's supposed to be, bro. So how was life growing up in Sac for you?
Growing up in Sac, it was pretty chill. I feel like I lost a lot of friends and family members. But I feel like it took a village like to raise me. Like I had a lot of like good and important people in my life. You feel me?
Like, sure, for sure.
In school, like my neighbors, stuff like that. So it wasn't like too difficult. You know what I'm saying? I didn't have, like, the most crazy upbringing, you know? Mm. So,
yeah, that's heavy, bro. Dude, take a village, you hear me? No cap. Because it's hard to raise, a kid by to the neck.
Right.
For anybody, you hear me? For anybody. That shit crazy to think about. You know, people really do that shit. Like, shout out to them, because that's real.
Yeah, for real.
Not crazy, bro.
For real.
So what kind of music you listen to growing up?
I first started off with a lot of gospel, so, like, listen to people like Kirk Franklin, Ty Tribbett, stuff like that. And then them was just like a gateway to other people. So like Kanye West and Drake and all that. So I feel like gospel kind of helped shape my ear for music because now I could like, I know what to look for and like I just having a bigger appreciation for music more.
You know what you're listening to now, huh?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Oh, God. That's tight, bro. So you was like Mary Mary.
Who else? I don't know if you know who Israel Houghton is. Like, he's fire. A couple other people. But they definitely helped shape my sound. And just, like, moving forward, like, definitely, they're the reason why, like, in one of my songs, I do want, like, a choir in, like, one of my songs.
It'll okay. Hit. Yeah. That's fire.
Yes, sir.
I don't be mad at that, bro. Sometimes. Yes, sometimes that shit's done right.
That's going to hit.
Oh, yeah. That's tight. Is that what your folks was listening to?
What? Like, gospel music? They were listening to gospel music, so obviously, like,
yeah, that's
kid,
what
I'm going to listen. So,
God,
yeah,
that's cool. So, what made you transition? You know what I'm saying?
I just wanted to see what else was out there, and like, really, I started listening to other stuff. I want to say, like, getting into middle school, maybe, like, because I didn't have a phone for a long ass time, like, and I was just. I would hear certain shit, so I would, like, go on, like, try to search up the lyrics, like, I remember on my phone, like, on like, Google or, like, on an iPad, whatever, and, like, go from there. But I just wanted to see what else was out there. I love jazz. I love R&B. I love all types of stuff. And I was like, well, gospel is kind of like a root genre for that. And, like, I wanted to see the other genres, so.
A little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Okay. That's tight. So what got you into making music?
What got me into making music was really just, like, the people encouraging me. I used to, like, kind of play around here and there and, like, put mixtapes out on SoundCloud and stuff. Like, I started, like, midway towards quarantine.
Okay.
I was bored, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I used to pencil tap, like, at school. Like, I used to always make beats and shit. And everybody would get around me. Everybody start rapping and shit. And I was like, man, maybe I could rap. You know what I'm saying? So I started making music. And long story short, everyone was like, bro, like, you're tough. Like, you should for real do it. And I was like, all right, bet. And there's a point in time where was it, I think it was beginning my senior year or something. I did a performance in front of my entire school. And, like, the love I felt from that, I was like,
What school you go to?
I went to Sac High, bro.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so after that, I was like, you know what? I need to.
That's tight, man. Yeah. That's tight. No cap. You hear me? That they even let you do some shit like that. It's
you know what I'm saying? Like, my dance teacher, shout out Miss Smith, she was like, hey, I know you make music. Like, you got one of your songs you want to perform? And I was like, okay, bet. Like, I did that, and, man, like, it felt good. You know, I was, like, I never performed at that, like, before, like, at that time, especially in front of every, like, that's a first, crazy first time.
That's tight.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, oh, shit. So ever since then, I've just been.
That's a great first experience for performance.
It was crazy. I was definitely nervous because I was, like, I didn't know what stage presence was. I didn't know nothing. I was just moving.
Out there.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Yes, that's fire, bro. Yeah. You play any live instruments?
Yeah, I play the drums since I was two.
Okay.
I definitely want to implement that in my music. But I really want to learn how to play guitar because my pops, he played guitar, and I want to learn how to play piano because my cousins, they play piano. So
yeah, trying to get that right.
Yeah, so if I can do that, that's threat. Less money I'm trying to spend on, like, trying to get niggas to, like, do shit for me. But I love it, though.
That's a triple threat, bro. Drums, guitar, piano.
Unstoppable.
No cap. and you rap and singing and shit? I'm like, that's it. You feel me? Quadruple.
Oh, God. I think her crazy. Is on some shit like that. Her, yeah. She's fire.
That's some real talent right there. You feel me?
Hella fire.
A lot of niggas can't even do one.
Right.
That's tight, though. For real, for real.
Yeah, it gave me a good sense of rhythm. Like, playing the drums, even though I'm not the biggest, like, guru on, like, oh, what are certain notes or whatever, but I do know, like, rhythm, so I know what. I don't know if that makes sense, but I know what sounds good. Like, I know where, like, okay, this could go here, et cetera. And it's helped me on my producer journey because I also produce. And I co-produced a lot of my songs and, like, fully produced a lot of my songs. So I've been, like, I just know where to put things, you know? And
right.
If I ever need help, like, I hit one of my producer homies or whatever, so.
Get that shit right.
Hell yeah.
That's tight, bro. So being in Sac your whole life, how you feel about the Sacramento music scene?
It's definitely growing. I just feel like we just need to improve on working together, which I think I'm starting to see more of. I feel like the city, I love the city. I just feel like there's a lot of clickiness going on. Like, there, it was a lot of clicks. Like, oh, like, he ain't really with us. He ain't really hanging with us. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, gatekeeping and all that shit, we can't grow like that.
That's not how that shit work.
Yeah, we can't grow at all like that. So I really just, like I said, I literally started taking music, like, for real, seriously, like, this year. Like, I've been pushing and working, and I've really been focusing on the networking aspect. Because, like, if you don't network, if you don't show face, if you don't actually put in the work.
Doesn't even matter.
You're not even going to grow for real. So I've just been focusing on that, and I just feel like the city, I think we're getting better at that. Like, we're getting better at, networking, and I just been throwing myself out there. Anytime I see an event or wherever, I'm like, I'm there. Like, if I ain't got work, if I ain't busy, I'm popping out.
Introduce yourself to as many people as possible, bro.
Exactly, so they can remember me. Yeah. That's how I got tapped in with y'all, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, man, y'all don't know me, but I'm gonna be there. Like, I'm gonna be at the kickball games. I'm gonna be at this. I'm
pop up, bro. Pop up. That should make a difference, you feel me?
Yes, sir.
People don't understand that one. Just to be there, you feel me? Just to be there, make a difference, bro. No cap. You never know who you're gonna see either. That's what really make niggas think, like, damn, bro, I could have been there and ran into so and so. But, oh, like, man. Yeah, you could have been there.
Literally.
That'd be that shit, bro. That'd be crazy to think about. But tell me how your vision for your future's changed over the years.
My visions for my future changed in terms of what, like?
Like, musically.
Okay. I don't know, like, how it changed. I don't know. I just never thought I would be doing music. Like, I did, but I knew I would be somewhere in a musical field because of the drums, but I never thought I would be, like, rapping for real. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. I just let it kind of play out, and I've just started to get better and better and better. And it's gotten to a point, like, I'm not even on yet, and, like, niggas be sending me my shit. Like, they're sending me their shit. Like, hey, bro, do you think this is good? And I'm like, y'all, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they send this shit to me, like, I'm already on, and I'm like, I'm not. Like, I'm still growing, but the fact that people do that, like, they want my opinion, they trying to see what I'm doing, et cetera.
I see it.
I just be like, man, like, it just feels surreal, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like the year is starting to end, but I feel like I'm just now kicking into, like, full drive. Mm-hmm. Like, I just started opening for, like, events and other people. I got a performance this Saturday in Walnut Creek. It's going to be my first, like, full set. It's going to be a 45-minute set. So, like, luckily I got 45 minutes of material, on, you know what I'm saying? Like,
come on.
I got two projects out, like, but those were from high school. I can't wait to drop my new shit. But, shout out to Kitchen. Like, he put me on for that. And, you know, it's going to be great. It's going to be live. It's my first time there performing, you know what I'm saying? I just performed in Del Paso. This girl named Shanae, she had an event called Tea and Poetry. My guy Brandon, shout out to him too. I've been having him come with me to my performances and live streaming, live recording all my performances. So that way, like, I'll throw it up as a live stream the next day, and like, it's documenting my shit. Like, not also for like the fans and like people to interact with me and see what I could do, but it's also for me because it's like,
see the growth.
Yeah, I can see what I can improve on each time. So. Yeah, it's been a
journey.
That's
fire,
bro. Yeah.
No cap. That's fire, bro. They really about to get my nigga 45 minutes. Bucko,
45 minutes, man. So I'm like, this, man, y'all about to be, like, ever since that the clip method, too, of, like, breaking shit up, bro, like, I'm already posting shit from my last performance. Like, watch when Saturday come. Y'all about to be seeing shit for, like, the next 2 weeks. I ain't gonna lie. Like, y'all about to be seeing shit from me, like, 4 weeks
fire,
in a row,
bro. I'm not gonna lie. That's tight.
Yeah, man.
So what inspires you the most to make music?
What inspires me to make music is really just my emotions. I'm not a killer nigga. Like, I'm not like, oh, I kill this nigga. Da, da, da.
Yeah.
But I definitely feel like I'm tapped in with my emotions. You know, I really, if I feel something, I that's why I think I find it really hard to rap cap. Like, where I'm like, oh yeah, I did this the other day. I killed this nigga, and I know it don't resonate. And if I say it, I ain't gonna.
Yeah.
I don't even believe that shit. You know what I'm saying? So. I really
capped to me.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit not real. That is fake.
It's crazy.
But yeah, I really just try to rap what's true to me, and I feel like Drake and Kanye West made shit like that cool, though. Like, they made that, like, possible for, like, rappers like me, you know what I'm saying? Like, that we didn't come from, like the streets, like, the trenches, you feel me? But, like, we still have, there's still shit to talk about. There's still a story.
Yeah,
you know? So,
life.
I still experience life, you know, so I really just try to stay true to myself, so.
That's fire, bro. Yeah, fucking with that. I'm fucking with that. How would you best describe the music you make?
I love smooth music. Like, it's just smooth. Like even when my energetic shit, the beats just be, like, they smooth. Like, they hit. Like, they just, I feel like I'm very particular about my production. Like, I like very, like, if my beats are busy, like, they're busy in the right ways. Like, right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really like rambunctious shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really pay attention to, like, noises and frequencies and beats and stuff. So I really
can't just be all over the place.
Yeah, all over the place. And I think I'm really good at having opening lines too. Like, it don't even like be something crazy, but I think my delivery and my voice, I think it carries a lot. So, like, if I get on an energetic track or whatever, usually I'll have like a really good opening line, and I just go from there.
Facts.
Yeah.
Let that shit ride out. What's your creative process like?
I live life, bruh. Like, it's so cliche, but like, I for real just be living. Like, and I think I create a lot when I'm in like busy environments. So like, if I'm at work, sometimes I'll randomly like get like a melody in my head or something, because like, I write a lot of hooks and like songs and shit. So a lot of shit would just come to my head. What else? I use my phone a lot. Like, when I write lyrics, I have two notebooks full of like songs I used to write. But once I started getting tapped into the studio, shout out to Pete. I've been like recording with Pete recently. He works at Amina Labs.
Mm-hmm.
He's an engineer there, one of the best engineers in all of like the city, bro. Like, he's amazing.
Wow.
He transformed my sound. But like, ever since I've been working with him, I've just been kind of almost freestyle, like, punching, rapping. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just getting in and just saying whatever.
Feeling
and just letting
shit.
It fly, yeah. And just using my phone and typing shit up. And yeah, and I just, it really just depends on the beat, too. Like, shout out my boy Vic True. He produced one of my recent singles, Stunner Girl. me and him worked on that, and like he'll send me like some dope ass beats, mm-hmm. and I'll just like listen to it and shit, and just catch a vibe, catch a, you know what I'm saying?
What was the thought process behind the name of the Stunner Girl?
To be honest, I was in my apartment and I was just like, I heard the beat and I really can't like put together what I really don't know where that came from. I was just like, you my stunner girl, you my sweet tea, bad bitch. But yeah, I don't know. Like it just hit. And I was like, I know people are gonna like laugh at that line, the bad bitch, big head ET line.
For sure.
But I know that they gonna fuck with it. You know what I'm saying? Like mm-hmm. it's humorous, but it's catchy. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to make something like that. And I feel like it successfully like translated too, because when I performed it in Del Paso, like I thought the reactions was hilarious. Like they was all laughing and shit, but they was also saying it and just getting the crowd participation. Like that's definitely I'm gonna keep performing that song.
That's a real movement, you hear me?
Yes, sir.
That's tight, bro.
Yeah.
Shit. You done any shows lately?
Lately, yeah. So, literally last Saturday I just performed Del Paso, okay.
And then,
the one in Walnut Creek this Saturday, and then right after that, oh, and I'm at Night Under the Stars, October 15th.
Okay.
So I'm gonna be there.
So too. You got some shit lined up.
I got some shit lined up, yeah, and I'm not done. You know what I mean? The year not over.
Yeah.
I definitely want to have my own show or like something similar to that, and like perform with an actual like live band. Mm. I love live instrumentation.
That's tight.
And I always wanted my music to have like live instruments with it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's gonna happen. So just stay tuned. You know, I got something in the works.
You done any collabs lately?
Like what, like features and
stuff?
Yeah. Yeah, I've been doing a lot of R&B features. Like I've been hopping on a lot of like R&B songs. Those okay. should be coming out soon. Shout out Monet. I just had a studio session with her, with my guy DB. He's an engineer. She has a really beautiful song. She reached out to me. She's like, yeah, like get on it. Whoa, actually, I hit her up first because she reached out to me. She was like, can we work already? And I was like, yeah, matter of fact, you got any songs? And she sent me this song. I don't know when it's coming out. I think it's coming out this month or whatever, but you'll hear me on that. Shout out Troy. He got a song called Love in the Backseat. I love my feature on that. Like, I listen to my own song, like, repeatedly. shout out Jay the Great, too. I just did a feature for him. He probably never gonna drop that shit. I ain't gonna lie. Like, this nigga like will get music and like hoard it and never drop it. But I'm on him about it.
He ain't never gonna drop that. But
okay.
You be listening to it though, huh?
Oh god, I'll be listening to it. You know what I'm saying? So it's whatever.
You could collab with any artist, dead or alive. Who you choosing?
Blast for sure. I love Blast. Kaylin for real, for real. Who else? Smino, I love Smino. Smino, one of my favorite artists. Rod 4-9. I think I told you about Rod 4-9, but he's mm-hmm. dope, bro. Like this nigga energy is top. He don't even rhyme for real. Like some most of the times he don't even rhyme. Like he'll just be saying shit, but his delivery is just what makes it
tough. So much better.
Yeah, I want to get on some shit with him. I know it's controversial, but I still want to work with Kanye West, bro. Like, everybody, that's still the guy, that's still the GOAT, bro.
I'm not mad at that.
You know what I'm saying? So, him, Drake, a couple others, but... Oh, I do want to work with Lucky Day, Summer Walker, Ella May for sure. Like, man.
That's hella funny.
A lot of R&B. I just love R&B. Like, I feel like, especially with my sound,
mm-hmm.
I have a very melodic sound. So I feel like I work like really good on like very melodic R&B tracks. Like all the features I've done recently are R&B songs. Mm. So I'm like,
I don't keep it going.
I would love to do that shit. You know what I'm saying? Get on my Lil Durk run. Cause Lil Durk, I feel like niggas don't give him enough credit. He is fire as fuck, but like this nigga's versatility is tough. Like he's on a lot of R&B niggas like albums, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? He's tough.
Going crazy too, yeah, singing yeah. shit.
Oh god,
like, damn, bro.
Yeah,
huh? Really yeah. the voice.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
That shit crazy.
Yes, sir. I'm gonna get on that type of run, you know. So
I get over there singing for real, bro. I wasn't expecting that. I'm not gonna lie.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I wanna get on some shit like that. So that's the way if I'm on. Like I'm all for the energetic shit, like don't get me wrong, but
mm-hmm.
I feel like that's definitely where I'm comfortable at, my like melodic, like baby, come back to me.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not mad at that. Yeah. If you could open up a show for any artist, who you choosing?
You ever heard of Aminé?
Nah.
You ever heard the song "Bad Thing"? Caroline.
Oh yeah.
Caroline.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
That's how you say buddy's name?
Aminé. Yeah.
Okay.
I used to think it was Aminé or anime or something.
I thought it was anime for so long. I still to this day I thought it was anime.
Nah, it's Aminé, bro. This
okay?
Bro, he is so far. Like one of my favorite albums for him. Definitely recommend you take it out. It's called Limbo. And it's honestly one of my favorite albums of all time. But anyway, this nigga, like, fan base is crazy. Like, this nigga is international with it. He be in Hawaii. He be in everywhere. Like, he's everywhere. He's always on the road. He's always doing shows.
And cracking.
And, yeah, popping his, like, it's a wide-ass turnout. Like, from Oregon, you know what I'm saying? He's tough. I love to open for him. Like, his shows be amazing. Like, I want a part of that. And on top of that, he just shows, like, he's popping, but, like, in his own way. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He's straddling the line between like I'm mainstream topping the charts and also he's not underground either. Like he's like known, but I feel like everybody needs to know more about him.
For sure.
Because he's been on his way, bro. Do you know who Catronata is?
Nah.
His producer. He collabed with him on like an album. They both make really fun music together. Aminé makes really fun music. Definitely recommend you check him out. Like, he's a true artist. Honestly.
Okay. Yeah, I just heard that Coraline song.
Yeah,
Caroline.
I'm
like, I don't know, bro. I just thought that was the only song Brett had.
Yeah, no. There's way more.
Yeah, I didn't know it was dropping shit.
You know,
that was hella long ago. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. I just never picked up after that. You know what I'm saying?
I definitely recommend it's worth the pickup, bro.
Okay,
like,
bet.
I really recommend listening to Limbo, bro. That album is like a true hip hop album.
I'm gonna go check that shit out.
Real shit, yeah.
I'm gonna check that out.
Hell yeah.
That's tight, bro. That's the first. Like, nobody said that yet.
What, Aminé?
Yeah.
He's tough. Like, I see him all the time. I be seeing him on Instagram. Like his shit be live. I be like, I'm a shit.
That's tight. It's usually a lot of Drake and shit, you know?
Yeah, and it's like, I love Drake. You know what I'm saying? Like, he narrated a lot of my life, you know what I'm saying? I'd love to open for him, but
that's
like
the bag.
Exactly. But like in terms of like other artists I'm a fan of, yeah, like excuse me, I'd love to open for Aminé or excuse me. Do you know Don Toliver?
Yeah.
Love Don Toliver. He's like dope. I'd love to open for him. If Jack Harlow is ever doing some shows, I'll open for him too, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out Jack Harlow.
You know what I'm saying? He's tough.
Right, him and Juski together are the
they need a duo, like they need a movie together. You know what I'm saying? Like they need a they need a buddy comedy movie.
Bro. Them niggas are hella funny together,
that's
bro.
What I'm saying.
Are you watching that shit? Like,
I ain't gonna lie, people were shitting on the White Man Can't Jump remake.
I didn't even watch it, man. You know it's so fucked up. I was one of the guys shitting on it, didn't watch it yet, and then one of my people was like, "Bro, the movie was actually
good. It's actually pretty alright. Like it's a cool movie. Like it does what it needs to do. Like if you're just looking for like,
I gotta watch it.
You know what I'm saying? Like if you're looking for like just a good laugh, like a good time, like on some quirky shit, watch it. You know what I'm saying? Like just watch
now
it.
I gotta watch it, bro.
It's good, bro.
I was just, you know, when they do the remakes and shit for movies, it really just disappoints me.
Yeah, because it's unoriginal. Like, there's no original ideas.
And they don't even do it good.
And they dilute the original materials.
They don't even do it good. Like, they did How High 2? I'm like,
oh, yeah. I saw that.
Come on, bro. Why are we doing this?
Or, like, the House Party series. Yeah.
Why?
I'm not going to lie, though. I low-key like the House Party series. Like, I like the newest one.
Okay.
I'm sorry. But
LeBron James house and shit. Like, what, bro? What's going on?
It was
on
entertaining.
Here?
I'm sorry. I'm probably like a smooth brain nigga, but like, I'm just easily entertained. Like, I'm like, man, yeah, this is not the original, but it's kind of weird.
You know, it's for like the younger generation and shit.
Yeah, that's
nobody. Nowadays, is watching old ass House Party unless you like into that type of shit.
Yeah, on a nostalgia wave.
Yeah, but LeBron James is in House Party now. They're gonna watch that and shit.
Right, he was in the Space Jam too.
You know what I'm saying, bro? You know what I'm saying?
I low key like that Space Jam too. But the original I think was better.
Crazy,
it was better.
Yeah,
but I have a heart for the new one. I'm sorry,
LeBron James. Hear me? That boy's getting a bag. I'm not gonna lie, bro.
Get your money, bro.
For sure. How he do two reboots, bro?
I don't even know. This nigga,
How he do two reboots like that, bro? Two classic ass reboots. All you time, and nobody even said nothing about that, bro.
Nigga, athlete, movie star, he do it all.
Nobody even said this nothing about this nigga rebooting two of the greatest, you feel me, movies ever.
Back to back. That's crazy.
Space Jam and House Party? This is crazy, bro.
Everybody love LeBron, bro.
That's madness.
LeBron sales, bro.
Yeah, that's crazy as fuck. I'm not gonna lie. That's tight, though.
You know what they call his son?
I don't even know.
You know what they call him?
Something crazy.
Lynette.
Damn,
bro. They call Bronny Lynette, bro.
I feel bad for bro. That's crucial.
They call him Lynette. I think it's crazy. Like, anytime, like, Bronny will post or, like, anything that shows Bronny, they'll be like, oh, Lynette is alive, or, like, Lynette posted. It's insane. I'm going to stop saying that. I'm never
saying that. Never say that shit again.
I'm sorry y'all did that, y'all. But.
That's crazy, bro. They out of pocket. I mean, it makes sense. Like, it's true, but that's just crazy, though, you know?
I know, yeah.
They foul. The internet's undefeated, bro. You never win against the internet.
That's what I'm saying.
So, back to regular shit.
Yeah,
you know
regular
what I'm
schedule program. Yeah.
How has your ear for music changed over the years?
How has my music changed over years?
How has your ear for music changed over
years? Ear for music. I feel like I've definitely, like, learned a lot in terms of, like, sitting in the studio. Because prior, I used to make all my music on my phone. Like, all on this. I used to take the Apple earbuds and just hook them up. I still do that to this day. Not in the studio, yeah. It's good for, like, making demos and shit. I place wherever the mic is located and shit. Kind of have it away from my mouth and just start rapping, you know what I'm saying? And then I mix in there. I edit from there. All types of shit. So just my ear for music, though, it's evolved because I know what to look for now that I've been in the studio a little bit now. I've used GarageBand a lot now. Like, never let a nigga tell you, like, oh, GarageBand is ass. Like, GarageBand is a lot of times, like, an outlet for a lot of niggas getting into producing. And it's been crucial in my career, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
A lot of niggas have made some crazy shit on GarageBand.
Crazy
based
on a GarageBand.
No cap.
Put some plugins in there. Import some shit. Your shit gonna sound just like the industry standard shit.
No cap, bro. Yeah. No cap. So what's one message you give to your listeners, your fans?
One message I'll give to y'all is really don't be afraid to put yourself out there. I feel like the judgments, how we think people will judge us is really just judgments we have of ourselves, like, internally. Like, oh, like, niggas will think you're weird or whatever. Like, that's what you think of yourself, you know what I'm saying? So if you could really tap in and tune that out, you know what I'm saying, and not even just tune it out, you know what I'm saying? It's okay to be scared, but just push through it, like, get through it, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, there's always something meaningful to get out of something. There's always a learning experience, you know what I'm saying? There's always something you could pull from a situation. So
facts.
I really feel like if you just, you know, change your paradigm, like, change the way you think about that, it'll go a long way. I feel like I just now recently, like, in a matter of, like, 6 months, started doing that, you know, like, where
finding, like, the positive and the negative.
Yeah, and it's like, you know what, like, in just embracing yourself, too, like, I know I be weird, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know, like, I be goofy, whatever, and I'm like, but I can't just be thinking about what others are going to think of me, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, I got to think about the task at hand, like, what am I trying to accomplish here? And a lot of times, your personality goes a long way. Like, sometimes people really fuck with you for just being yourself.
No cap.
And it's like, you know what? We fuck
most
with you.
Most of the time.
Pop out. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you'll start getting invited to shit. You'll start like, yeah, you know what? This guy, like, he provides good vibes for us. Like, we don't feel weird around this nigga. Like, he actually, like, makes us laugh. It's a good time. Come through. You know? So, just don't be afraid to be authentically yourself. Life just too short for all that. You.
That's fire, bro. Yeah. I like that.
Hell yeah.
A lot of niggas be trying to be somebody else.
Yeah, all that cool guy, mysterious shit. Like, nobody knows you, bro. Like, nobody knows you. Like,
and that shit
and
don't
like,
matter,
I'm saying
bro.
That for myself because I used to be, like, not like, oh, I'm a cool dude, but I was just like, I was just trying to kind of on some antisocial shit for a little bit where I was just like, man, like, I'm a cool ass nigga. Like, shit gonna come to me. Mm-hmm. Like, it's gonna follow my lap. It's not work like that, bro.
Turns out it doesn't.
Hell yeah. So, like, the moment I started actually applying, like, advice people give me and things I would learn and just really applying my eagerness to just get up and go, just do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, not, no pun intended, not no Nike shit. Just do it. You know what I'm saying? It opens so many doors for me. And I'm like getting in spaces and rooms with people I never really expected to be in a year ago or even really 6 months ago. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
So, yeah. Shout out DJ Eddie, by the way. I was just in her music video shoot on Sunday.
Shout out to gang.
Yeah, so I just with her. Thank you for allowing me to pull up and
she
stuff.
Be turned up.
You know what I'm saying? I definitely want to work with her. So just coming to that for real, because we actually never met. Like she followed me back on Instagram. I sent her my music. I was like, hey, like you should like, I'd love for you to like spin my records and whatever. But that was our first time for real meeting and like everybody around and all that. I met there's a guy named Nate Curry. Like he's cool. Love his music. I checked out his shit like after, like his shit is fire. But after that, I was just like, man, like I'm gonna keep popping out. Like this is what networking is, you know what I mean?
I promise you, bro. Show face.
Exactly. It gives people the ability to capture the essence of you.
Mm-hmm. You know, so. Cause they can see all that shit on Instagram.
Hell
or
yeah.
Whatever social media you got, the shit don't matter though.
Exactly.
Especially if they never seen you in real
life. And
that's
life. So scary. Like niggas really live on here. Like
I promise you.
Like,
bro.
Oh, if you got X amount of followers, I can't fuck with you. I'm like, what? Nigga. Like it's weird. Niggas, it's so weird.
It really blow my mind, bro. Like,
yeah.
Niggas be you don't even make
like
no
that. That's what
don't
I'm
even
saying.
Make no money off that motherfucker.
That's what
either.
I'm saying. Like
you got 50,000 followers. Tell all them niggas to send you a dollar. Can't do
they ain't
it.
About to do it. They ain't about to do that.
You
shit.
Just drop an album and have everybody buy it right now for $1. You hear
nobody
me?
Nobody about to do it.
Nobody's doing that, bro.
No
ain't bullshit. That something, bro?
And y'all over here talking about something, man, bro.
Can't fuck with you.
I can't fuck with this nigga.
What? Niggas be lame as fuck. Worry about Instagram followers and shit.
Oh, man.
It really be blowing my mind. Niggas do live on social media, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, there's not a whole outside. But, you know, sometimes not outside. Outside is not for everybody.
And
so.
Social media, like, it's a tool for sure. Like, it's,
hell yeah.
It's helped, like, shape my image and
hell
all that.
Yeah.
But there's only so much the internet could do. Like, I feel like your reach on internet is, like, hella important. Like, it's
for
strong.
Sure.
But, like, when you get those people in real life, that's always going out.
Way heavier.
Like, the stats, all that. Like, that's
way heavier.
Way heavier. It's still true to this day.
Niggas could not have a social media and still be so relevant in real life.
Right.
You hear me? Like, to the fullest extent. Never have any of that shit and still be so relevant in life, bro. That's crazy to think about. Niggas really think their phone is the key.
It's not. It's just a tool, bro. It's just
I
a stepping
you,
stone,
bro.
Man. Like, there's so many, like, artists, too, that, like, their numbers or their Spotify numbers or, like, their Instagram, they popping.
Man.
But they can't pack out a show.
You
they can't
do
shit.
Shit.
You know what
can't
I'm saying?
Do
so
shit.
I've been trying to make it my duty as, like, an upcoming artist to, like, tackle both areas. Like,
mm-hmm.
And I've really been, I thank God that I've been starting to get now, just now, into performing and shit. Cause now I love the essence of performing in person and getting like those interactions and shit. Now when I actually throw my own show, I'm really thinking about, okay, what can I do to like capture more people? What can I do to make it a more meaningful experience in person? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, I feel like I've got a pretty good idea of what to do online, but really focusing on it in person now. Like, that's
what makes it
that's
difference.
My focus right now. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Ever since my last couple performances, I'm like, this is the focus now.
That's where it really come into play. You feel me? Like, the internet and shit, that's like the gym. Like,
yeah, said, that's the gym. Okay. And I've been treating all these events I've been opening for as the gym. Like, I've been treating all that as, like, training grounds to, like, what? Like, I'm watching back my highlights, you know what I'm saying? Like, seeing what I could do. I'd be like, oh, I don't like that play.
Right.
Oh, like, actually, let's change it. You know what I'm saying? So after that, like, I just keep improving every time. Like, perfect example. I performed at the Guild Theater, right? And I had my guy, Brando. Shout out to Brandeezy. He recorded me, and I noticed this was dumb, but, like, my lips was on the mic, you know what I'm saying? So I was over there, like, just, like, and it was affecting, first of all, the way my voice was traveling because, like, it would kind of muffle my voice. But on top of that, like, there's germs. I don't want to, like, walk around with, like, you know, take the mic off and I got, like, herpes or some shit. But, like,
no
you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, so I'm like, you know what? Let me just...
100% though.
So
bro.
Then,
I
actually performed in Del Paso, I was like, "What can I do to actually?" So I just started like, it's like, be quiet. You know what I'm saying? But it's like, kind of put space between your lips and the mic, so that way people can hear you, and you're also like not getting like
Herpes.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Herpes, yeah. So it's like, you ain't got like STD juice on your lips and shit, so.
Because you don't know who the fuck is on that.
Yeah, like you don't know who got boo-boo butter on the shit and all that. Like, you know. Like boo-boo butter on the mic is insane. Like you got that shit. Like you don't know where the mic been at. Like.
That's hella funny, bro.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like.
You don't know who got boo-boo butter on the mic, nigga. No kissing.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you don't want that shit on your lips. So I was like, actually,
that's hella funny, bro.
And then my energy, like, on the stage improved, like, tremendously since my last one. Like, so I was like, you know what? I'm getting more comfortable. I was, like, I posted it on YouTube. Like, it was only, like, I condensed it down to 8 minutes. It was 12 minutes, but it was, like, a lot of extra shit. But in my performance, you know, I was, like, I allowed my personality to show, like, very charismatic, very just interacting with the audience. Facts. I feel like crowd interaction is so important.
Number one.
Hell important. So.
Number one, bro. But that's the people who's listening.
Hell yeah. So
saying?
I want them to feel involved. I want them to feel like they got something meaningful out of it. So a lot of times I'll be like, hey, repeat after me.
Yeah.
If I'm in the earth, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want people to feel it.
Soak that shit in for
hell
real.
Yeah. So, yeah.
That's tight. So what would you be doing right now if it wasn't for the music?
If it wasn't for the music, man, I'd probably be... I was still an artist. Like, I was drawing and shit, making my own comic books. So I probably would be, like, pursuing, like, some kind of art studio or something, or, like, trying to get sketches into movies or comic books or some shit. Like, I always wanted, like, to have, like, be in, like, Pixar movies and shit. Like, I used to make my own, like, original characters and, like, sketch out shit and, like, watch videos and copy, like, characters. Like, I love shit like that. So, I definitely want to implement that with the music, though. So, like, I'm designing my own merch and stuff. So, I'm, like, I could have, like, different designs and shit. So, I feel like that would translate well.
Okay, so you about to drop some shit for the people then.
Yes, sir. Like, shit, I'm excited, man. The year's almost over and I'm, like, I feel like clear-headed than ever. Like, I feel more just, like, locked in now.
Focused.
Yeah.
Come on, man. That's how it's supposed to be, bro.
Hell yeah.
So, you got some new music, anything?
Yeah.
Anything hop to let the people know
before you go? I'm about to preview a snippet. It'll probably be out by the time this drop, but it's a song that I'm working on called Place to Be. Very, like, chill, smooth song. And I'm working on an album that'll be out around my birthday in March. Titled Young and Restless.
You got some features on there?
Yeah, I definitely do got some features. I just been like trying to keep it on. You know what
I'm saying? Can't drop no names.
No names yet, but I definitely like can't wait to pop out with them. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it's gonna be a moment, and I'm just setting up all the cards now, so when it drops, like, it's out.
And, you got some exclusive shit.
And I just can't wait for it to drop, because I have more new shit to perform, because I've been on a singles run. Like, I've been dropping singles all year. Like, but I can't wait to perform shit from a new album.
You know? Yeah,
I'm not dropping an album this year. Like, I haven't dropped.
Let me find out you got a little baby on that motherfucker.
Shout out my label, that
Yeah, let me find out you got a little baby Drake or somebody on that motherfucker.
Not yet. I'll let you know.
That's tight. So you got some shit coming. Merch. Where can the people find you before we get up out of here? You know what I'm saying?
Instagrams. So I go by the name of Josh P. You can find me on Instagram at Josh P. From CA. So J-O-S-H-P from and then CA, like from California. And yeah, you find me on YouTube at Josh P. Apple Music, Spotify, Josh P.
Josh P.
Yeah, everywhere.
Well, you know, well, before we get up out of here, what made you go with that, bro? What made you just stick with the Josh P?
Josh P was really, thanks to my sister, it was just really just a simple name. You know what I'm saying? Because I remember it was actually during the pandemic I came up with that name. She helped me come up with it because I was like, I need a stage name, but I don't want to go by my government. But I don't want to go by, like...
Something different.
A elaborate-ass, like, fucking, like, doofus-smirch-ass name, you know? So I was like...
Niggas didn't want to be Evil Incorporated?
Yeah, oh, God, like, Perry the Platypus type shit. So I was like, you know what? Let me just keep it simple, Josh P. Like, it's short, it's simple, and it's catchy. Like, every time they be like, yeah, it's that new Josh P. Or like, man, like, my boy Josh P's a young... Like, it's just easy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it just lets the music speak for itself. It's like, man, Josh P is tough. Like, it's hard, it's catchy.
Mm-hmm.
So... Yeah, and I don't think I'm ever going to change it. I don't know. Like,
rock with that shit, bro. Josh P, you hear me?
Hell yeah.
All right, gang. I appreciate you for tapping in with another one. You know what I'm saying? We out of here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. We clapped up. Okay, say less. Oh, God.